Fallout 76. The story that became not interesting, very interesting, and then very not interesting again, within 24 hours. So, somewhere yesterday, we got that still image of the play standby. Which, I mean, I actually have my tweet here about that, about what I thought about it. Peculiar. It's either a Switch port again, something for Fallout Shelter, good game but I don't think they'll hype for it, or more Fallout 4 DLC, which is also very unlikely. So I was pretty convinced that this very colourful image was just something was going to announce that either Fallout 4 or Fallout 3 or something went to the Switch, or because that's just kind of something that a lot of games do at the moment, they go to the Switch. Then we got the trailer, and it looked very Fallout 4-esque. And, well, basically when I had a 1 hour long walk today, I wrote stuff down about my thoughts on it, about how it could be because Starfield is taking so bloody long that maybe a part of the Bethesda team is working on this instead, because, well, you have to do something, I guess. And that it could be very interesting, as all the problems I had with Fallout 4 were just written problems, so maybe if they just make a completely new story within what Fallout 4 is, within the Fallout 4 system, well, that could be very interesting. And I just had all these thoughts about why Fallout would make sense for that and all that type of stuff. Yeah, that's thrown out the window now again, because some information that we got via Kotaku, at least via their anonymous sources, so I don't know how trustworthy they are. Maybe they are very trustworthy, maybe they are not, I do not know. They are saying that it is a multiplayer survival game. Now, this would obviously give off signs that it is something very ESO-like for Fallout. And, well, I of course like ESO. I've been pretty clear about that, that I am not against that game at all. But, well, for one, I think that The Elder Scrolls World lends itself a lot better to an online thing. The test world is just a lot better for large scale, large amounts of players, consistency within the world, sort of. While Fallout just, I mean, it would maybe suit with a PvP shooter game, but it could be something Titanfall-y maybe, but this? Just, I mean, of course, this is very nothing. A online survival game, also with building and stuff like that. That sounds very nothing. But okay, so it's a game published by Bethesda that I don't care about. Okay, that's not really something very special, because, well, it's not like I have to like everything Bethesda does, but, well, to understand the next point, you have to understand that Bethesda Game Studios, that studios actually has a reason for being studios instead of studio. Because Bethesda Game Studios has three places they work from. Two of the three worked on this. Both the Maryland one, which did stuff like Skyrim and Fallout 4, just the thing people know as Bethesda Gaming Studios, and Austin, which it was Battlecry Studios some time ago. I don't think it's a studio anyone knows, because I think the only game they made, because they worked on a Battlecry game which never came out, which was their main thing, if I'm not mistaken. But yeah, resources from Bethesda Maryland, just the Fallout and test guys, have been spent also on this online game. I've talked about this in the Rage videos, and it will be a big point in if I ever upload my predictions for Bethesda's E3 this year, which I really shouldn't wait with, but yeah. A theme in that will be, I'm excited because I like Bethesda. Bethesda normally does great stuff, but I worry that they might do stupid stuff, that they become one of those other mainstream companies. This is the type of stuff I worry about. Did they sacrifice the guys that made things like Skyrim and Fallout for making this online game that they can keep selling you stuff in? Because, well, that was one of the things with ESO. Yes, it is a test game, but it's not made by the test people. It didn't take anything away from what they were working on. From the information I think we now have, it seems pretty clear that this time they did take away resources from those guys for this. Now, I could be completely wrong. I mean, we know so little. Just, I'm drawing this information from anonymous sources on Kotaku who I do not know very well. But what I am hearing is worrying, to say the least. And it's the exact worry that I brought up earlier that I had for a long time. So, let's hope I'm wrong. Let's hope that this either is something completely different and that these anonymous sources are lying. Or let's hope that just they were wrong in that. I don't know, I just hope that I'm completely wrong in all of this and that Bethesda just also announces their big Bethesda RPG this year as well, because that's kind of what I predict was going to happen, but now I do not know anymore. So yeah, that's the disjointed, false rambling, worries, annoyings of me about Fallout 76. Let's hope I'm wrong. This has been Vinix saying farewell.